the restaurant, we headed to the park. Alright guys, look at Devontae, he said he ain't gonna do much talking. Cause he tired. But we starting our day off eating some cupcakes. Yeah, my hair is wet. I need
only
to.
Black people do this.
Do what?
Eat sweets in the morning.
Child, we eat everything in the morning.
Pizza.
And spaghetti.
Yeah, this one tastes better.
Yeah.
This one tastes way better. And yeah, you can get off of this one.
Oh, hold it. I need something to drink. Dick.
Water. I'm 7 minutes away.
Okay.
You got everything?
Mm-hmm.
LSD, too. Does your
closet? Mm-hmm. I'm buying my, those are some off-brand. You want some juice? Want to drink less? I'll tell your ass water. To my boy. Water. I don't see your ass drinking no water.
I can do that. I'm a birthday boy.
Your birthday was yesterday.
It's still my birthday.
I mean, Wednesday.
My birthday all month.
Hmm.
Uh-huh. I'm glad they got breakfast because I'm starving.
You hungry?
I didn't eat. Well, I mean, I ate when I got home, but that was like when I woke up, probably like around 9 or 10.
See, I had Crystal. And then I had got 4 Crystal and a chili cheese poke. Didn't even get to eat chili cheese poke. I guess cleaning up took way longer than expected. I thought I was going to be quick folding up them clothes. No, I was not quick. It took me forever to do those clothes. Mm-hmm. All right, so we're in Dexter's Sky Club. And I have a mimosa. All right, so this is the view from the Dexter's Sky Lounge. See the planes. Yeah, guys, so I had 24 hours of sleep. I spent all night packing and cleaning up too. Then, of course, my flight got delayed, so I'm a little annoyed about that. But it gave me an opportunity to kind of like sit down. I said, L'Oreal, I could fall asleep in this chair. So I was like, it's close enough time to the time that I set my alarm. So I was like, let me go ahead and get up because I would hate to miss my flight because I fell asleep. And I'm sitting here like 5 walks from my gate. So yeah. And the bus said he's already going. He was on Southwest and his flight took off at like 8 o'clock or 8:30. Yeah, it took off at 8:30. So yeah, he will be waiting for me again. Look at these planes, y'all. They're just taking off. All right, guys. So it's time for me to head to my gates. Hopefully, we have a quick boarding time. I'm ready to get to where I'm going. So, yeah. I'm gonna show y'all a quick glimpse of the Sky Club. Alright. And I am headed to my gate. It's nice in here.
Bye, ma'am. Have a great day.
Alright, bye.
Thank you.
Yes. Oh, guys, look at some gates.
Where's Nick?
Oh, she was lost so we were looking. It's almost morning time, guys. Almost. My legs are already so like, get on this flight and go to sleep. I'm so tired. I had like a whole day of like sightseeing plans. But I'm not 100% sure that we're gonna make it or whatever. Because I'm like so tired. But I feel like I can do like a quick power nap. And I'm gonna need a nap. So hopefully like we get to the hotel, the room is ready. And then I can take me like a nap. And then we go like sightseeing or whatever. And then we get ready for like happy hour. And we go to a night out. So yeah. All right guys, so our flight was delayed. Almost an hour, so I'm finally on this plane. I am ready to take off. I'm so tired. I will check in with you guys once I finally land and see. But I might have closed my eyes. Alright guys, so I finally made it to DC. It's been a while since I've been here. I am excited. I'm just trying to figure out like where my bag is. Which carousel? They usually tell you. Let's see, they usually tell you like where your bag is after your trip. But, yeah, I didn't get the little notification of where my bag was. So. Womp womp, we're gonna find it. She was gonna cut me off. Alright, so should I see Reagan? So again. So oh. I'm trying to find the bus. I don't have time for the six and back and forth when we try to find people. Gotta.
Y'all, I finally found his tail. This man has the worst sense of direction ever. Look at him. Look at him. Look at him, y'all. But now we finally about to go. We're finally about to go to the metro. And this is gonna be his first time riding the train.
His first time riding the train, guys.
So you get to see us. A little different than Atlanta, don't it? A little different than Miami too, don't it? Oh, you talking about, oh yeah. I guess Delta get the convenience. Huh? Bro, I don't know what happened. I guess we were waiting on some staff or something. And it's like, they told us, I'm thinking like the plant shot. I hadn't got nervous because here, I'm sitting up in the airport lounge here, my eyes closed. I kept falling asleep. So eventually I had set my alarm clock. But I was like, I don't want to keep falling asleep. So I was like, okay, we're supposed to board at 8:57. Get there. Child, everybody just standing there. I'm expecting, I pull up late. I'm expecting like every morning. No. People just standing here. Then I look, flight delay after I done left the lounge. I'm like, damn, I could have had more mimosas. Like, because that's what I had. But yeah, you ain't missed nothing with the food. The food was lacking. That one was. That it was lacking. Which is crazy because I had when I had flew to Houston, the lounge that I was in, the food was good, but it was a bigger one. But I think the tea gates must be for the early flights. Cause see, when I flew to Houston, I had like a 2 o'clock flight. I had an afternoon. Whew. All right. Hold on, I'm gonna pull off to the side so I can put this camera up.
Okay. 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 Okay.
Devontae on his first metro ride. How's it feel to be riding a train? Yeah. So then it tell you right here so you can see what's the next stop. You gotta say what's the next stop. So it always tell you, and look, there's a map right there. So you can see we getting off at Farragut West. After Foggy Bottom. Now we're underground. You heard me? You scared, you nervous now that we underground? Yeah, if you ride the metro in DC, it's all underground. Yeah, it's all underground. So man, let me talk about, it's this one on DuPont Circle. You gotta take this long. I mean, it's steep, but it go down. And then, like for real, and then it's get darker and darker as you go down. And then when you get off at DuPont, it go up. And it's like, oh, the light is opening. Yeah, huh? It's probably one of them prongs. I had to eat that Biscuit cookie, I was hungry. I was. I gobbled it in like 2 seconds. I was being like you, Devontae.
Yeah.
I was being like you.
I thought you.
Child, I had to direct you to your mouth earlier today. All right, guys. So we done checked into this hotel. We about to go grab us some lunch. Lunch snack, I should say. Much nice. I mean, it was clean. It was clean. Okay, I want to say no. That's why I say it was clean. All right. So here, I'm gonna let you hold the camera. And then wait, you can't walk yet because I don't know where to go.
And it should be on that corner on the ring.
How would you think so far?
It's cool. I mean, I haven't really seen anything yet.
It's a lot of buildings.
It's a lot of buildings.
Yeah, it's definitely a lot of buildings. Sure. But we kind of a little. We should have stayed at Farragut's a little bit. I mean, near Mount Vernon. It was a lot more. It's a lot more booming over there. But I guess it really don't matter because it's not like we're gonna be in a hotel. And I think if we was just coming here to like tourists and all that kind of stuff, then I would have picked a different role or whatever. But you kind of look like somebody else. I would have picked a different room, but today is like the only day that we're gonna really be sightseeing, and we're gonna spend most of our time in this room. So it's kind of like, who cares?
Yeah.
And then too, around here we like bar hop or whatever. It's easy to just, you know, go. Pre-COVID, I don't know how it is after COVID, but we just hop in that Uber and go.
Yeah, because you haven't been here in years, right?
Nah, just 2 years. I last came in 2021.
Okay, that's not that bad.
No. It wasn't that bad. We went to 8th Street, but we went
So it'll be real nice to have them.
French fries. I need me a snack. That's real life. Whew. I probably
gonna
lose weight while I'm here.
No, just walk harder.
Man. But that's what I was like. When I moved.
Oh, man, is this Indonesia or the Philippines? Which one? Philippines? Okay. Yeah. That's what, see? Boy, I'm telling you.
Made it.
Was that the right word?
Yeah.
Okay, let me finish that. You want the other one?
Made it to the White House. What's that right here? Devontae! Y'all, I'm at the whole Devontae. Man. It's perfect for the picture. All right, so did you enjoy seeing the White House?
Yeah. It's a lot smaller in person.
It is, right? Didn't I tell you it don't look like how I do it on TV? Every time I see them portray DC on TV, I be like, this is not how, like, they always stick their little monument on there, and then that's it.
I bet they got snipers on the border.
Oh, yeah.
You see where I tried to pop over that
time? Yeah, they said so mad. But I know, yeah.
Fedez, come out.
Listen. And then how you know this? Well, you know the ears always listening.
Stop.
Yeah, we just need to go this way. Yeah, we'll ride the bike or scooter back.
Keep on going, you help the homeless get
back. So, that's what we're gonna do. Oh, yeah. I'm surprised when you see, well, actually, we was at the wrong metro stop. Shoot. Come on. I think that's for like a whole little class thing, though. But you can book a tour, like a Segway tour.
Just walk down there to take a look at the north front of the White House. If you want to do that, you can. If you don't, you can just hang out.
I'm impressed. Well, you can't just walk up in. I don't think we can walk this way, can we? It is the North Executive right here. Oh, that's people coming from work. We'll just have to go this way. Oh, we're going to pass Trump. I think Trump Tower on this road right here. Oh, yeah, them people work over there. Look, you can see, look. Man, look at the dress. Didn't I tell you they dress different up here? For professional clothing. No, they ain't coming from work though. They tourists. I'm talking about professional wear. Yeah. Man, I am here for losing 10 pounds because I've been walking. Yo, DC is so walkable. That's why I gained so much weight in Atlanta. Because Southerners do not walk nowhere. I can't remember what, I think they have like walking scores or whatever. And I think DC had got like 90 something. And it's one of the top walking cities in the country. I mean, in the country. Yeah, I think that might be the number one. Yeah. Oh, yeah, so here in D.C., food trucks are really popular. All right, so we just need to go to the right. I think, let me check. I always like to check in the corner. You hold this? I always try to check at every checkpoint to make sure we're going the right direction.
Yep. We are. See? Walk straight down 15. But really, when you be walking and talking and like sightseeing, you don't realize like how many steps you actually like put in. Like on a weekend, we would come out here to go to the National Mall because it's like a circle or whatever, like a rectangle, not a circle, it's a rectangle. People be out there jogging. So in Captain America, and you know, when he was jogging and he kept saying, on your left, on your left, that was supposed to be the National Mall where they was jogging there. We seen that rectangle with the water in the middle. That's where we going. Yeah. So now it makes sense. I mean, now you're gonna see, like, oh wow, this is what they was trying to portray. Yes. Oh, Epic Grill. I was just literally talking about that place to that girl today. About old Abbott. So a lot of politic people be. DC is very politicky. Mm-hmm. I used to say, when people don't talk to me about politics. I don't want to talk about politics. All right, y'all. Here is the African American Museum. We're gonna try to change this out Monday. Right? But yeah, this was built. They built this while I was living here. And when they had first opened, it was hard to get tickets. They was doing like a lottery. We had to sign up online. Now after the hype has wore down, you can just go there. Or whatever, you don't have to make reservations, you can just walk up. And a great thing about the museums here in DC, free 99.
Free what?
Free 99. It's free, you don't have to pay to go in here. See, it's already, it looked like a lot of people over there. That's why I said Monday be the day to do it. But yeah, so here we are at the National Monument. Yeah, that thing about to blow me away. It was hot. Whoa. Look at it, guys. And we can get closer. You can take, we can take pictures. Now let me keep track of the time. Not Apple Watch. I might look like you working out. So, yeah, because I said we're going to start heading back by 4. No, I mean 3:30. I said 3:30. Damn, we got 30 minutes. Yeah. If it wasn't for my damn flight, we would have been out here. So this is a good place to ride bikes too.
Hell yeah.
So this is where we wore bikes at. We rent bikes. I know, let's see if they got some bikes because I think they got a cup holder. I don't see any. They usually have a rack. Lime, they got a lime bike. I wonder what it's a station around here somewhere. But we can just keep walking and see until we see it. Yeah.
Because I was. You always see them when you don't need it.
Bro. You don't see it. Oh, is this it right here? No, that's cars. It's cars parked. Oh, you want to go right here in the grass?
Yeah, we can.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, we can actually see it now.
Ooh, look at that boy. He got his camera right tight.
Okay.
breakfast at the hotel. We got bagels, muffins. We got the waffles. Ooh, they got red velvet. And then malted vanilla. I don't know about that one, y'all. It's the waffle maker, the toppings. And this is oatmeal. And then they have cereal. Okay. What is this? Apples. The fruit station. The yogurt. Oh, they still got Chobani. I love some Chobani now. Yeah. Oh, okay. This is where the food flowed at right here. They got cheese omelets, potatoes. They got sausage and bacon. Oh, they needed some grits. All right, y'all. I'm about to fix my plate. All right, so we have the coffee and tea station. Yes, I always bring my own tea or whatever because I never know, like, they always cater to the coffee people, but places never cater to the tea people. So I usually just bring my own stuff. So yeah. All right, guys, it's day two. You gotta press the button because I ain't pressed the button. Basically, we're being in D.C. And we got up this morning and we went, got breakfast. We did a little bit of walking with the H&L Sephora. So now we're about to head to get something to eat. You ready for our day two? It feels so weird. Like, I don't have my own tripod or whatever.
Yeah,
just so, like, it's the stick or whatever. So I had to hold this way when I was I mean, that is true for, yeah.
Y'all can't tell me I don't look good in paint, y'all.
Sunny
out here. Y'all can't tell me I don't look good in paint. Only real Negroes wear pink. Put a fit. It is crazy. Man, this Mika.
she got on her paint too. She looking at the directions, y'all. Cause we gotta walk. We gotta walk, walk, walk. I'm probably gonna lose like 2 pounds. That's about it. That's about it.
Oh, okay. Across the camp.
So what direction
we're
going?
We're gonna pass by OCO, one of my spots.
Cool.
It's across me, I don't need a lot of time to match me up.
I know God did, God did. Nando's. You made it.
Yeah, I don't know.
Alright, so these are the different sauces you can put on your chicken. So this is the lemon and herb, but I like the garlic one. I never had the wild herb before, but I'm gonna do the garlic one. Yeah, I kind of want to try the wild herb. I never had that one before. So get a little bit of that one. Sanitizer. What else? Do I need ketchup? Yeah, I'm gonna get ketchup. Alright, Devontae's full. He got the wrap. Oh yeah, these are my fries.
Our fries.
Our fries. The ones you didn't want. Mm-hmm. So I just waiting on my food, guys. Yeah. Start eating. I ain't even got another drink. Thank you. And I'm just mixing my drink.
What are you doing?
Orange mango lemonade. Alright, here's mine, y'all. It came quick. And that's why I'm glad I did the 1/4. Whatever. Metro, we head into the park. We're going to Brooklyn City. It's time. You ready? Let me see my drink. No. Hurry up and drink before I can get there. Yeah, we are here. Yeah. Now this the hood side of Southeast. So yeah, this the Southeast. S-O-U-L.
No.
Like Maryland ain't. Maryland, it's not Maryland, it's Maryland.
He's old though. Even when you knew
my high school.
Yeah,
high school.
Oh, you want the rest?
I thought you meant like
before I toss this.
Okay.
I wonder if they gonna get them. I wanna see that. Maybe. You know, people try to do everything. Oh, we got like a little 15-minute walk. So hot. Yeah, but it is. That's what I like too about living here. As long as it's like technically, you really don't have to have a car here. As long as you live on a metro stop and everything that you need to do is metro accessible, then you can just, or you know, you can take the bus. Some people, I'm not really a bus person, so it has to be metro accessible, you know. And then, you know, you car. So a lot of people would come out. Beauty of this is we just follow everybody else. But the thing that everybody always came out for me because Oh, yeah, the car look like they about to go. The beauty of it for me is that when I used to host stuff at my apartment, I was metro accessible. So people could take the metro and walk to my apartment. And then if you didn't live metro accessible, when you was looking at like apartments and stuff, what you want to do is find an apartment that offer free shuttle Monday through Friday to the metro. Yeah. So. So yeah. So once you get your apartment, whatever you need, just ask them if they offer shuttle to the metro. Cause some apartments, like my very first apartment, what was it? My very first apartment, they did. They offer free shuttle to the metro, Monday, but only Monday through Friday. Yeah. So technically, and then my first apartment, the grocery store was walking distance. You can walk across the street. American Deli was, I mean, there's America's Best Wings. So that's what franchise they have for wings. That was a walking distance across the street. So it's just a lot. I hear stuff. Is this the right way? Yeah. Oh, we have to go all the way around.
Is that like a stadium, like Boston football?
No, it used to be. It used to be the old Redskins stadium.
Oh, yeah, I forgot the Redskins.
I mean, Commanders now. Yeah. It's a new name. Yeah. But yeah, it used to be their stadium. And then they moved to Maryland. So their stadium is in Landover. I think that's technically Landover. He got a nice job. He in the air conditioner. Yep. I think a lot of people must have already be there because the metro was not packed. The metro wasn't packed, so I wonder if it's a lot of people already here. Yeah. So this like neighborhoods right here. So these are like houses. They call them row houses or whatever. And people actually live there. Yeah. You see how close these cars park together? They need to park like that. And yeah, you see why I be like, this is what I'm used to. We're going to street parking? Because baby, trust me. Listen.
I think yesterday, well, I don't know where we were.
You have to do the.
I'm like, damn.
Me and Bree called it. Look, I had to learn. I tell everybody I learned how to parallel park living here. Because you have to know how to parallel park to live in DC. And me and Bree call it the toot toot and the beep beep. When a space is so small, you got to move a little bit, back up a little bit, move in a little bit, back. Then we got it toot toot and the beep beep. Because sometimes you got to do that too. Huh? Saying what? Oh. I want to find me some pink ones. I used to have some and I hate so bad. I had some bubblegum pink and white ones and I hate I sold them.
You know which ones
I don't know what number it was. I just know they were Jordans and they were pink and they were bubblegum pink and white.
I don't know about number, but I know that I don't know
what it is. Exactly. Oh, y'all know where you're going? You just follow everybody else. Because we all going to the same place. Watch your step.
Make sure you watch your step.
I am. Woo, woo, woo. I'm going to let you hit me, too. So I'm sure he got a backup camera and seen this.
Yeah. It's like how you do.
Yeah. Do they let water bottles in here? Because now I'm wondering. I see everybody with a water bottle. Crossover. I see a lot of blue bands. A lot of green. I wonder what color VIP is. Is that Saucy still on? Might be still on.
What's Saucy?
Saucy Santana. He started like 3-something. Yo. It's a lot of people. Damn, we forgot the sunscreen. Damn. And you must can bring a water bottle in here.
Shit, I forgot the sunscreen. I forgot to put under the
Oh yeah, me too. The band. Hopefully we don't burn. Uh-uh. Cause it's all one line, I thought. Oh. Oh, I guess we can go right here. Me either.
Yeah.
They said if you don't have a wristband, wow. These probably people just bought their ticket the last minute. See, I've been dead hours. As soon as they announced it, I did it.
Bruh. I wouldn't even waste no time.
But ain't you glad your girlfriend a planner? Yeah. All right, let's go do an ID check. In this case, we decide we want alcohol. That's what this line for. So how was day one at the festival?
It was a lot. But we made it.
So any parts of the festival you enjoyed?
That I enjoyed. I'll probably say the best performance was probably City Girls.
Yeah.
It was crazy.
All right, well, I ain't gonna hold y'all too long because I just want to show y'all my food. We had Bus Boys and Poets, so this is another one of my favorites. I have the Cajun shrimp. It's supposed to be chicken and chorizo, sausage, pasta, so I cannot wait to eat again. This is one of my favorite places. Not only is the dinner good, but their brunch is so good. Like, I love their mimosas because they use freshly squeezed orange juice. So I'm about to dig in, guys. Alright guys, so it's day two of Broccoli City Fest. Yesterday wore us out. Now we're here for day two. We had a late start of our day today. So we missed Coco Jones, unfortunately.
It's 4 o'clock already? Oh damn, it's 5.
Yeah, we're gonna make it in time for Glorilla. Cause Asake, the Afrobeats guy, then he brought me on right now.
Yeah, I heard about it.
So then we got Glorilla. So we're gonna get here just in time for Glorilla. I'm excited to see her with her little deep voice. Her voice deeper than Coco.
Her voice deeper than mine.
I'm ready for a fuck, nigga, freak. We'll catch up with y'all later. Y'all, it's hot as fuck.
Right, yo.
y'all. The trip is now finished. We are currently packing up. Well, she is currently packing up. I'm already packed. But
no, girl's taking a while. I gotta get everything up. I got everything in a disarray. I'm trying to ring it back in.
Yep. So
my stuff on the same side.
DC is over, y'all. Time to go back to the nitty gritty.
What is this?
That's my mom.
Oh, this from Delta Sky Lounge. You want to put this in your suitcase for you to snack on?
Okay, let me get that. I'll take that, y'all. I'll take that.
Oh, this is what I had meant to put in some water yesterday.
Was that the crystal water shit?
No, it's like the liquid IV, and it's supposed to give you a lot of hydration, like boost your hydration. Yeah, because they was giving us this. Look, this came from Coachella. Let me see if it's still not old. Oh, it was still good. May 2024. I did Alicia buy this? Alicia might have bought this. But I remember when we went to Coachella, and you just added to a full bottle of water when we went to Coachella. They had this out. They gave us like three different flavors. And then I remember Alicia, when we was in Houston, she bought one. And it's good for keeping you hydrated.
It tastes good?
I don't know. I ain't never had it.
Sometimes I don't think it tastes nasty.
Right. And that's why I said I ain't never had it.
But yeah, we enjoyed the trip, man. Like, for real. Last night was the best night. Broccoli Fest was the best last night, yesterday. Headliners all day.
I know. I'm on my AirPod. Let it charge the last 15 minutes.
You missed Coco Jones, but...
Oh, no. I think she might be coming. I need to see if she coming to One Music Fest. So... Oh, yeah, you gotta make sure you get your ticket or whatever. Because if she's coming... Because I think Mariah the Scientist is coming back to One Music Fest. I know Brent is coming to One Music Fest. Yeah.
Yeah, it's gonna be a banger. It's gonna be a lot of bangers out there.
Yeah. Let me pour this water out.
Yesterday, Mariah Scientist did her thing. Gorilla definitely did her thing.
She did. Gorilla was good.
Gorilla did her thing.
I was like, okay, Big Flo.
And the good thing about her, she know how to interact with the crowd. That's a good thing. Who was Kodak Black? Even though he ain't really performed, but he still did his thing.
Yeah, we ain't gonna talk about Kodak Black.
He from my hood, y'all.
Yo, y'all fuck with me, learn how to give a damn performance. We ain't paid to see you bob to your own music. We'll see you got that going performing Kodak.
Cause it's funny, cause at first everybody listened to music, and then it came to a certain point. I think everybody was just like, okay, are you gonna perform the song, my G?
Listen, we were.
Are you gonna perform the song? Cause that's how I was into it. But I ain't allowed to jam to the music though. That thing.
I was jamming to the music because I like Kodak Black, but I was like, bro, are you performing or no? Because
he was in his own world.
Bro, I mean, he didn't pull it out of the blunt, start smoking.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm just like, nigga, are we in your studio?
For real. You know, who was after Kodak?
It was Brent.
It was Brent after Kodak?
Yeah. That's Brent Fires after Kodak.
Oh, I guess it just feels so long because
it was a long set time between the two of them.
Yeah, and then in between, they playing all this music and dragging it out. I'm just like, that's probably the only thing I did not like, too.
Well, you know, they have to like do the different, I need to make room for the crown.
Yeah, that's the only part I didn't like, they're dragging it out and all that.
Well, they have to, because...
I know they got to, but it's still, it kind of, like, even before Brent came out, that joint was dragging out so much.
Okay, this is what I'm trying to tell you. It's not that since this was your first festival, it's not that they're trying to intentionally drag it out. It's time in between set changes.
No, I get
that.
So
you can't really see, like, but they're changing up the set, some of the equipment. Some people want extra stuff.
No, I get all that, but I'm just saying that's the only part I didn't like, though.
Yeah.
It just, cause especially between him coming out before Brent came out, that was like a whole hour.
Uh-huh.
That should have been like at least 30 minutes. I feel like they could condense that time.
Well, then, but see, and this is another thing.
He's an R&B singer. Oh, yeah.
Well, no. So, listen. So, this is another reason, too. Not only set changes, but we have two different stages. So, in between that set change from this stage, what you're supposed to do is walk over and go to the other stage where there's, because there was performances going on in between that set change. But nobody wants to move because no one wants to lose their space, so you're stuck standing there. But the festivals, that's how they do it, too. Mm-hmm. It's a set change, one, and then two, it gives you an opportunity to go to different other stages to see other artists perform on the other stages versus just standing there.
But you know who else was performing, like, during that time at the other stages?
Yeah, Lola Brooks.
Oh, like those other people.
Don't play with me.
Okay.
Yeah, she was performing.
I thought it was going to be on, okay, got you.
She was on the other stage. So that's what the time is for, too. You go to other stages, but no one moves.
Yeah, ain't nobody moving. Once you in that crowd, yo, ain't nobody moving. It's going to be hard as hell. And it was. Yeah, Broccoli Fest is not for the week.
No, festivals, period.
Festivals, period, yeah. It's not.
So, yeah, so that's what it is. It's a set change. Plus, it gives you time to, like, go and check out the other artists at the other stages. So, the idea is if you're bouncing back and forth, then it would seem like nothing. Like, you're not waiting. You're not waiting or whatever because you're bouncing back and forth in between set changes.
Right.
And so you're still constantly seeing artists and performances.
Yeah, but overall, it was fine. It was fine for overall.
I didn't even charge this soap.
Of course, Saturday was cut short, but...
Yeah, Saturday was like a mess.
Yeah, Saturday was crazy.
Then we got rain on. Trying to get the bus boys and boys.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Sure, you done went to buy 3 different scooters.
Yeah, I had to buy 3 different scooters. First one kept making that noise, a beeping noise, and when to go. I'm like, what the hell is going on with this thing? Then the second one, the lock, it didn't want to unlock. And then I had to use a third one. But out here in DC, they have so many damn brands. They got like 10 different brands out here of scooters.
Everybody trying to compete with each other, huh?
What? That's one thing I say. Y'all got scooters for days. Y'all got scooters, bikes.
We got a lot of public transportation. There's no reason why you can't get from point A to point B.
For real. And then if you don't got scooters or bikes, you just get your feet.
Yeah,
walk your life away. But yeah, man, we had a good time. We was lit. Got home late every single night. So yeah, it was fun.
I'm almost done. Okay, so I am packing this punch over. You got no room?
Hmm. Yeah, I could just throw it in here.
Well, my suitcase is looking tight.
Yeah.
I'm almost done. Just getting a little corner right here. Yeah, it's not like
they're gonna be like, oh,
it's
7:00.
Check out. They know people being
moving
slow.
Services. Yo, this bed was comfortable too. This bed was so comfortable.
Some of these pillows. We need better pillows.
I enjoy
Where did this money come from?
It's from last night. What I gave you.
No, I already had some. A wallet right here. Yeah. That's why I don't carry cash. Oh, wait. Let me get my lottery. This could be positioned in my witness. I ain't had Trump ticket yet. Look, don't judge me. I ain't had Trump ticket.
Nah, do your thing, 21. Do your thing. Yeah. Damn, that's crazy though. Only 4 performances yet? We saw your 4 performances today? Damn.
Alright, so this is our lunchtime snack. I'd say I already digging in per usual.
We had Panera. I got the chicken and wild rice soup. She only got me a little cup because I'm trying to save all my appetite for the lounge. But we're going to the African American Museum today. Yeah. Two of my favorite soups. I'm glad I did get the cook, man, because can you imagine getting a bowl? All
right.
Bro, tell me about it. You know, I said you've been trying not to overeat. I'm gonna go back to eating small portions, multiple, like six small portions a day. All right.
But I built a minute. I got
a little shit. All right. All right, guys, so we're heading towards the National African American Museum. Devontae has never been.
Had to walk up his
food. Oh, yep. By the time I get to the lounge, guess what? I'm going to be good and hungry. Yeah, that was a perfect little thing. I get a little cup, then just do the cup of soup, and then I can have dessert or whatever. So that worked out great. Worked out great.
Are you going inside of that?
No. Oh, I don't know. No chance, because it's looking like something like you can,
yeah,
right there.
Like
maybe. I ain't never been inside. Interesting. Let's take a right here. But then my mom came, it was under construction. And so every time I've come, I don't know, that might be new. I don't remember being able to go up though, because it looked like it's some doors right there.
One of us, what's the purpose of that building?
Uh-huh. Who knows? Possibly.
All these ice cream trucks that we have out here.
Yeah, this is a food truck capital, okay? There be food trucks everywhere.
Good.
Yeah, because the food trucks be good, bro. Is this one? So one of my...
I have ice cream every day.
No, of course you would. But no, so my favorite, how I learned about that chicken and donut sandwich. So there's a food truck, and they used to come by my job. So they have a food truck. Then there's this other one called Faux Wheels. They have Vietnamese, they have faux, but I like their Vietnamese tacos. Or whatever, we get Vietnamese tacos. And then this other one, it's called DC Empanada. And they have this buffalo chicken empanada that tastes like buffalo chicken dip inside the empanada. See, that thing is so good. It's my favorite one. And then at Broccoli Fest, Roman Rooster, I'm getting a rock in my setup. Okay. Roman Rooster, Roman Rooster was at Broccoli Fest, and that's a good one. They have chicken sandwiches too. Roman Rooster is very popular. So food trucks is where it's at in DC, okay? Like for real. You can, and then what they do, all you do is you pull up, you get into a parking space, and you just set up right there for the lunchtime, and people come and order food. And then you just post your location on like Twitter, Facebook. That's how you figure out what his food trucks are and what location they're gonna be at for the day. Yeah. Which is very smart. So you literally can start your own food truck business and make money doing the food truck business. That's why you see so many people out here with food trucks.
All right.
Yeah. See y'all? Y'all see the food trucks? Yep. And you know, of course they're gonna be out here with the tourists in too.
Yeah, yeah.
But food trucks typically aren't that expensive though. They're really affordable. And there's the African American Museum right there, guys. There it is.
Hey, that's a downside up pyramid. That's a downside.
Yeah. Right here's the museum. And it's right next to the National Monuments. Now we're back. So this is the last thing that we're gonna be doing. Oh, look, they have this.
Black Panther costumes in there.
Yep. In the Bank of America Special Exhibits Gallery. Oh yeah, okay. All right, guys, we are here at the museum. Let's try to find one. Try to find an exhibit. I want to try to find an exhibit. The one where yeah. Oh, you can see what floor the floor is. Cause there's multiple floors. Let me see if they got a map. Over here.
Attention visitors.
So we can get a map or whatever.
And playing
so you can see which
one we actually want
to see. We're not going to have time to come in the whole building.
And will result in an escort out of the building.
Oh. Here. Scan your phone. Up right here. All right. So quiet.
I'm in awe.
In awe. I know, it's a thing, like they were building this when I was living there.
Oh, for real?
Yeah. It's
not a process of them building.
Yeah. I mean, from the outside, yeah. But, you know, we couldn't see, like, the inside. So when they finally opened, when I tell you it was so hard to get tickets, because everybody, yes. Not even just the DMV people that live here. People from out of town was trying to hurry up and come. So it literally, like, they only used to release tickets. Maybe it's all the way at the top. Let's just keep going. So yeah, they used to then open up like tickets. It was like tickets was like on a Monday or whatever at a certain time. And then everybody like logging into the website trying to get tickets. It was like difficult for a while, for a couple months, like to come in here. And but as time went on, it got easier and easier for us to like get tickets. It got easier and easier. So now you see how easy it was for us to get tickets today. And it's less crowded too. Like, of course it's still summertime, like for people on vacation, but as far as like on a weekend, it's less. Maybe we can do your mama like magnets?
Yeah.
Your mom like magnets? Sorry here. Does she like magnets?
Magnets?
Yeah.
Like post up
in. Yeah, I'm thinking like I think we should get, you know, we can get a souvenir.
Yeah, put on fruit.
Do this. Oh, wow, this is new. The activist stuff. They always have new stuff. That's why I was like, I love comment. Like, no matter how many times you come, there's always new stuff.
Thank you.